Myself, Ankita Tiwari, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, from IT ICT department. I am going to take a session from the subject that is computer vision. The subject code is 3171614. The module that we are going to cover is module number 1. Module name is Overview of Computer Vision and its Applications. So basically we are going to learn about what is a computer vision, also the different applications that the computer vision have. Also, the session we are going to cover is the introduction part. So here, starting with what is a computer vision. So computer vision is a field that includes methods. Methods for what? Acquiring, processing, analyzing. For what? For understanding the images. So basically, if we say an image, image comes in a different perspective in different scenarios. So basically, we need to understand image by understanding the scenario also where the image is being present. So it includes acquiring, means first of all see the image, acquire the image, in which includes processing, where the image is being processed with the scenario where the image is present, also analyzing the different areas of the image, different parts of the image, and understanding the whole image with everything. Now that processes that I have already told right now, that includes first image analysis, then going forward scene analysis, then image understanding. Also we can say that finding out the image in a particular scene. Now all these things we can say duplication of the abilities of the human vision by electronically perceiving and understanding an image. So we say that here the human vision, which has been understood by the human as our mind, that is being duplicated, means that is being converted in the electrically form, where the perceiving and the understanding of an image is being done. Now that part includes our eye. What a human eye reads, analyzes it, that record is being saved in a particular system where the sensing device will analyze the image. So this is what I have talked about, the computer vision, which is being compared with the human vision. Now initially the human vision was only there was no computer vision. So how a human vision is being analyzed by as an image? So that thing we are going to learn in computer vision itself. So here the goal of the computer vision basically is to write the different computer programs that can interpret the images, because computer vision is also being done by the human itself. So human needs to understand how an image is being analyzed, to formulate it, okay, using mathematical calculations, mathematical formulas with respect to the size, the shape, the distance, okay, everything. So that will be converted in the form of programs which will be given to the system in order to analyze it. So basically the first part comes here as in human vision, how a human is analyzes an image, that will be converted to the computer vision. Okay, now with respect to that, the image data, okay, the data that we are getting, taking it in the form of image, will be in many forms, such as video sequences, means a video, particular video we have, and in that particular video we need to have a particular image. So that is a sequence, okay, because it goes in sequence and we have to capture one image. So that is also a form of image. Then we can have depth images, then we can have views from multiple cameras. We have different types of cameras as well in our system, and we can use any of them in order to get the image of a particular object. Also we can have multi-dimensional data. That multi-dimensional data goes from a medical scanner. Now this is what medical scanner means. Here I'm talking about the x-rays, the different body part scanning which has already been done and which is already been going on in the whole world. So basically the goal of the computer vision, in order to use it for a very good purpose, for the very good benefit in order to scan a particular image for our good purpose. So that things, how it is done in this system, how the computer analyzes it, scans it and gives us a result. So that thing we are going to learn in this whole subject. Now we are having different forms, as you can see here, a robotic man is there, half portion as a human and half as a robot. So how this image will be scanned, okay, because we are having in the same image the two of the different forms. So how this image is being scanned, okay, so these are the different forms, okay. Then we have black and white images without color, okay. Also we have the X-rays image form, so that is also a form of data only, in the form of image only. So these are having different of the forms that we are we have to scan it, how it the system gives as a result of these different images, okay. Now we'll talk about basically the first thing that comes in mind, the human vision versus the computer vision, how both are being related to each other, okay. With respect to that, here as you can see, this is an image, okay. Now this image is what we see, okay, means we will see this image, we will be seeing like this only, okay. But if I'm giving this image to the computer, how the computer will see this image, okay, it will not see like this, it will see like this, means the binary code data, okay, means any of the image also is being stored in the data or is being analyzed in the data as a data in the system with the binary data, because system understands only one language, that is machine language. Also we can say that it's a binary language. So every data can be of different forms, like hexadecimal code, okay, octal code, decimal code. So these are the different forms of data, but system understands only one language, that is binary, that is 0 1, okay. So this is the image that we see and that is the image that a computer sees of the same itself, okay. I'm not changing the image. So this is how a computer vision and a human vision. Now with respect to that, we will understand how a processing is built up, okay, how the processing works with respect to computer vision and human vision. So as you can see, I am taking an example of a tomato. As you can see, tomato is red in color, and we know tomato, if we see a tomato, then first of all, if I'm talking about the human vision, as we see, it goes to our eyes, because eyes is the only body part in our system where the visibility comes, okay. So tomato will be seen by our eyes. That eyes will not give you the result that it is a tomato. No, it will see that it is an image. Now that image is a eye image, a tomato image or not, that will be decided by our brain, because brain stores all, we can say brain is a memory where all the image data is being stored here. So first of all, the image will be struck to the eyes, it will go to the head. Head will give you direction that it is a tomato, and then head will give the result as it is a tomato. Okay, so basically we can say that in a human vision, how the data is being seen, initially the object will be given to the eyes, from the eyes it will struck to the brain, and from the brain it will give you the result. But result will be in the form of object name, means recognition, okay, not the analysis. I'm talking about the two things. In human vision, it is just the object name, okay, not the analysis part, okay. That analysis comes in only computer vision. So here the same thing will be applies to where tomato is being placed, it is red in color, okay. When tomato is being sensed by the sensor, or we can say sensing device, we have different sensing device that we are going to learn, okay, in this subject. That sensing device will senses the image and it will interpret the data in any of the form which will be given to the system. Now the system will analyze it, will be convert, the system will convert it in the machine code. That machine code will be given, giving you data as human readable form only, but in the form of, like, tomato contains 18% minerals, 12% vitamins. Means if I'm talking about 2-3 images, like tomato we have, apple we have, peach we have, then it will give 80% or percentage of tomato we have, 15% of apple we have, 1% of each. As you can see in the diagram itself, everything is clear. like it will give the analysis of that image, okay, not the name of that image, okay. So this is the basic difference between a computer and our brain, okay. We can just see it, but we as a human being only who is designing the program for the computer vision itself in order to analyze this data, okay. So that is a different perspective, okay. So this is the comparison between the human vision and the computer vision, how it goes, okay. Now going ahead, as we know computer vision, but computer vision, we say that it's difficult. Why? Because it includes pattern recognition, it includes image recognition. Image recognition comes with different varieties of size, distance, calculations, mathematical formulas. So we can say computational part is very much more available in computer vision, because we need to analyze the whole image with respect to distance. Distance of what? With the camera, with the film that is capturing the image, okay. So we say that first of all, computer vision is difficult because it is the concept of many to one mapping. Why? Because we are having a full scene. In full scene, we are having many objects, but the computational thing which is going on will be done by only one system, that is the computer. So this is many to one mapping, which is, but of course, difficult because the system is scanning different images at the same time. After that, we are having another concept, as if it is having many computations, like many mathematical formulas, calculations, distance. So, but of course, it will be difficult because we need to understand the different concepts of mathematics as well. We do not understand the recognition problem because it includes pattern recognition, image acquisition. These are the different acquisition problem that as a human is very difficult to understand and that to incorporate in the system as well. So these are the different criterias from that we can say that computer vision is difficult, because this computer vision program is also being made by the human itself, okay. So the different areas that the computer vision includes is pattern recognition, image processing, artificial intelligence, mathematics, physics, signal processing. So we can say computer vision will be helpful in these many areas, and where these many areas will be, we are using some part of it where the program will be defined by the human itself, okay. So here the different areas will be helpful in order to design a particular program for a image formation in computer vision, okay. Now we are having different computer vision methods, as we have image acquisition. I have already told you image acquiring, okay. After that we have pre-processing, then we have feature extraction. Different parts of the images is being analyzed differently in order to get the features. Detection, which is also known as segmentation, also recognition and interpretation. We say that interpreting the data, okay. Also the different mathematical concepts that we are going to learn. Now these are, I am talking about just the points of it. We are going to learn in depth, okay. After this, the calculus we are going to learn as a mathematics. Then linear algebra, you are already familiar with. Probability and statistics that you have already learned in the last semester. Signal processing, you have already learned in networks. Projective geometry, computational geometry, optimizational theory and control theory, that you are going to learn as a new concept in computer vision subject. Okay, so that we are going to, now these are the different mathematical problems, solutions that we are going to have it in our computer program that we are going to learn after this, okay. After this, we are discussing with the application part. Application includes controlling processes. Then we have navigations, where the computer vision is being used, detecting events, different events, organizing the different information in a particular format, modeling the objects or the environments that we already know, 2D model, that is two-dimensional model, and 3D model, 3D view, you already know. Interaction, also the automatic inspection. So these are the different applications where computer vision is being used, okay. Now the most important benefits of computer vision: the simpler and very much faster. Fast computers basically replaces lengthy visual checks, okay. Reliability, we know, cameras and computers we can rely on, because I, as a human eye, get tired. System that is camera never get tired. So this is what the factor is. Accuracy, your final product will be, as thanks to computer vision, flawless. Okay, a wide range of use, ranging from banks to medical, where it has been used as in banks, now it is using in medical care, as you know, cameras, 3D scans, 2D scans, x-rays, this we are using in medical care. Cost reduction, as we know, we are saving time on people and devices. Faulty products are eliminated. So this is what the benefit is, and these are the different areas that we know in, and we are already knowing it. Okay, so this is what the thing is about the computer vision. I've started with the introduction part, I've end with the benefit part and the different concept that we are going to learn in this whole subject. Okay, so we are going to learn after this, after introduction, we are going to learn different parts that I've already told you. Okay, thank you.